what this was showing. Molecules that are inside every cell, and they work. Another part of this somehow they pull out the things in this very that's literally thousands of cells. Meaning, way faster. Taking the DNA, putting a red, putting it, moving it all around, all this other stuff. You have cells. How does the heart know how to beat? Ever thought about that? We haven't. We don't have to. It should always beat. That causes it. How does the heart know how to sleep? How does the blood know how to cut? How does it do all that? You must know it. He's a nurse. I'm a doctor. I'm a doctor. Thank you. Well, how does it know how to know how to make how do the sperm and the egg know how to make the organs, arms, legs, eyes, are infinitely complex. So within a little bit, like all the ovaries we're going to have in our entire life. That how does it know how to do it? It's got to be some incredible cause. In body. DNA. What is our conclusion by looking at the question is what caused the universe? The answer is must be an uncaused cause. Order, something that defies science. Reality is there is an order in the universe. It seems that the bang doesn't. So there must be some cause. Nothing can create itself. How the universe is. Object and matter. All that nothing can create itself. thing. The universe cannot create it. If it was created, if it's a moment of creation, it was an explosion, we could get order and beauty. See all these on inside. The Aquinas of all of this. The question is, I of all the knowledge that filled us. Really, all these aspects, God, how do you continue to find revelation? Know this cause to this. How we got there. Nothing material world, the universe, has ever existed on its own. It created it. The universe is an extended growing like all you got to do is ask it why, and you are forced into the answer that Aristotle came 2,400 years ago and called it. Cause that is uncaused, that's the only way you can explain accurately. If everyone understands, when you're talking, I don't believe that exists. Well, we agree that there has to be an uncaused cause. So let's just keep calling it the uncaused cause. And they're going to be cause. Cause exists. That's fine. But we both agree. So there's five ways that Thomas proves it. Does God exist? And Thomas goes on in the Sutta. So that not only God does not exist, but pure perfect, good, infinite, unspeakable, he's all knowing he is himself, reality. The rest of it already proven. Now we got to look at it. So I've asked this practice really carefully. 5 years. reason, the vast majority of them, they can't go anywhere. What are they going to do? They can't stay in the bathroom forever. I don't talk to them. That's the most important thing. But I don't do it in a Bible. That's what I would do. I would just keep asking questions. What I do in all my homilies and what I do in all this known as the what method, static method, Aristotle, eight Greek philosophy. So, static method, daughter of Plato, his dialogue. Read any of Plato's dialogues? And it's like a place. So much. Well, Socrates, all Socrates says is it's called exercise. Why things are, and he has to find things. So then, I use that Socratic method, right? Conversation. I have that I found time. What I found was very, very time. Different places, Catholic, their college level of their own state. So it's gotten to me. I would get into over the course of about a, at the end of this 12-hour conversation, I would how God's revelation, not only the Bible, but more importantly, how we're to say that the question I have, whether they believe in God or not, if God is all powerful and all loving, he desires to keep his very nature, who he is, God, most of us. Man, okay, that's the answer. Well, let's say, actually, people, so the keywords are the most effective. What do you think? What do you think? I mean, I've heard, what do you think? Oh, well, if God, you know, wanted to, like, okay, well, you're going to learn about this God. It's the most what do you mean by it? I'm playing hardball and classic. This is not a question about Jesus. It is, what is the most effective way to communicate? And what answer, what do we respond to? miracles. That's good. Miracles. All these things. I don't know. To me, write a book. All these. The reality is, even if there be a couple of things that there, I want you to know about God. We're going to be given $1 million in the context of the certified world. In 7 years, you know that person. The very nature of the world you can answer. So, what do you want to have done in that? Being a child of living is the answer. This is the answer to the question. If God is all powerful, which means he can do anything, and he's all loving, and he wants to communicate that, it is, brothers and sisters, only unanswered. Nothing to do with the Bible, only to do with human love. That's the answer. Right? So, not a human being. The next question is part of it. Okay, what answer is better than the one? Pointing out it's true, but not wrong for God or satisfied. You're dealing with an equal. Okay, an equal is play hardball. And say, look, you're assuming God exists. Don't tell me that I have this longing for God. I don't have this. God exists. To that question, there is, of course, the answer has nothing to do with Revelation, Bible, or anything else. Pure mind, God. Ask them. David Smith, the founder of a religion, the only person to claim who thinks Michael, God, nothing to do with the Bible, they think so. Is the most effective. They may choose to not believe it. There is no other answer. All of our knowledge comes through our senses. All five senses. All the beginning of something to all five senses. It's a book. That's only one. It's only one. String. I shared this with and at the University of Alabama, our cleric, we had seminarians covering Pittsburgh, down to Pittsburgh, and all the students. They're going up the students. Being very polite, we sit down and we talk. Anyway, so we were on the and very polite and respectful. I I just want to know that I'm saved. That is a lot. All the things that you try to say and demonstrate can all be explained. There is no. Okay, I know you don't believe. I know you don't believe it. We're all powerful and can do anything. Or know what you want me to say. I want you to answer the question. The question is, God must become a human being. I'm not saying it's Jesus. In other words, you're kind of forcing them to seem like people are being religious, and I'm saying, no, you can't be religious. Like a complete role reversal. So you're using science, knowledge, and logic. Him or her, to themselves, God, and if he was a personal, how did he? If I ask you. I ask this question a lot of people, lady, what do you think? What it all came down to was sacrifice. Those people that loved them the most were pouring out their life, which love is, right? God is pouring out his love in the first thing. About suffering. All these attributes. All these other things. Even alone. Basically, God is that which nothing greater can be. When you think about it, when you really think about what it's saying, what it's trying to do, it becomes humbling. Because this is God, God can create something out of nothing. Or we can. God creates only what is powerful. So, the idea is God is that which is created. defined. Is God all loving? So, just like we had to define science, that's love. That's classical, Catholic. Willing. That's what it means. It's so sad that so many in our world. They're falling out of people believe that love is a feeling. That's so detrimental and cause so many. Love is not a feeling. Love is willing the good of another. Nothing to do with your emotions or self control. Willing the good of another person. All loving will freely give one another and I think I so dear ever of the love of the ghost I represent Trinity is one. Himself as a community, lover as father, one is love, and the love that goes to the Spirit that wants to come to God Himself, the Son, comes in human form, puts Himself perfectly to his sin, and is sacrificed to love with nothing and dead. In his own power, but as a divine being, raises himself up, back up to the Father, said, wait, I'm going to send the Spirit to see the love between the Father and the Son across all the apostles, all the disciples, empowered with his gift on high, raised himself fully. Fullest manifestation of giving yourself fully to the Lord and to the faith, your faith. It's like total self sacrifice. So, the blood of the martyrs is like when full selfless giving. They're motivated. Hard, our by grace, God is all love. So, great, evil act of love is now what we're going to do. We're marching toward the God's all power. Let us start with we're in love. Great is the act of power to create something out of nothing. Modern science is flabbergasted. They know, scientifically, that nothing is created. So the universe is here. And it's perfect. Scientists, and I'm not saying all scientists, many scientists are, and there's can't believe in God. Like, you have to help all these things that make no sense in the mind. Nobody knows that you actually think. Pause Aristotle. Years ago, it's built to the truth. It corresponds to reality. It corresponds to all that we know in science. And being the truth, something is nothing. Ultimate, some uncreated being can do that. Uncreated being, same thing. word about love. All right, now we're getting into something. Love is, right, responsibility. So we are created in God's image. And woman what does that mean? What we come to learn is what we need to be made in God's image. Right? That's the purpose of God. The question is, what quality do we have that is God's made in God's image? This is what we do, and that's intellect and will. Every human person is created with intellect, mind, intelligence, right? And animals. Animals aren't eating butter and having fun. We want to know truth and reality, because God says there's something that God put in our heart for the truth. So what God has put to us turned in. We have to tell it, God, what are we going to do today? Good? God was harder. So he's like, good. I'm going to be selfish and it's cause of all work. We all know we're not perfect. We're all doing this perfect way. Compliment. Pray. Learn. I realize that's what I learned about. Will. So, all that to say, as we have human freedom, will, like God, open, possible for us to be. But without freedom, there is love. Freedom. Otherwise, they're like puppets on a string. Power, God is all powerful because he's something from nothing. And the second thing is to not hold. Literally, or look at what's going on in the world. Look at what's happened in the 20th century. World War I, World War II, Ukraine. God is not stopping anything. Because he loves us. He's going to constrain us. Like, nope, I'm freeing you. I'm giving you intellect, but I'm not giving you any will. I'm just going to let you harm another person. I'm not going to let you harm any. That would make sense, because then there wouldn't be suffering and evil. If God already created things like that, what do we call them? Animals. God already created creatures that cannot sin. Do evil and immoral things called animals. Not that I want. does with it. And one, when we see this is what the fall is, what Adam and Eve is telling us, we're in that. Man takes that something, which is the freedom to love and to do good. We are the cause of the consequence of our life. Of us, the lives of the so, this doesn't really need to be really good. So, right, we're going to be stirring in on this. How God can die the suffering evil. He is all powerful and he does nothing because he does whatever we want. The only allowing all this suffering early or reality going on. But the only solution to or kind of pull everything back up. It's all about it. That's what happens. It's not loving us. It's the only answer. Fine. All this. Hey, somebody raise your hand. Hold it. You would have to be captured. The way we all just said, if you were captured, you would not be free. What is the solution? In other words, you cannot. He has to make up for it, and how would he have to? No, I remember you talking to an atheist. Would he have something you're farther down the road than I wanted? What would he have? We go on the right track. What is it? Well, make up a difference is where I'd like it. The power and human has that power for none of this argument. Yeah. Okay. You with me? See, the only way that we can be good is to allow that to happen, and that evil that's happened turns it into good. What is the event in human history that shows he has the power and love to do that? That's his son, is what? Died on the cross. That's the part. God himself allowed this to happen. He died just like we all did. 3 days later, God and man really did something. He keeps himself up. God raised up his human nature. That is the victory. That is good. That is the triumph. Good over evil, brothers and sisters. We know this, but we maybe just haven't heard it said this. When you listen to all the super prayers, and you look at all of the readings we do over the years, and everything the priest prays, so you can get the sacrifice on top of the pulpit and prayer that is awesome. This is something in there. What has he done? God created us good. We threw it. He came to us. He looked at our human nature. Just like God, who is one, has blessed us to comprehend this. He had to experience it in the most effective way to show his love for us. He must be the Romans. Our sins put him on that cross. We know that. Our then God blew us away. God did people of those human suffering and no sense. God has the power and love and soul and suffering. Only that is why suffering is death. That's why we have every Catholic Church. You don't need to pray. I can go. And the fact that he lives among us and dwells in us with us tabernacle is totally a holy. You don't have to fear to live. You don't have to die, and you don't have to live. God is with us. Dwells with us. God's sacrifice, outpouring of of himself, right? What he told us all along, top right, love is to will the good of another. All loving means to will freely give oneself to others. That is. All of, so having this understanding, now we're getting happen. All the God is awesome. It's mind blowing. You feel it when you have this. All these things explain to a person. It's an atheist or it's truly honest. They follow your line of reasoning. How do you think the Bible? How is going to make this? Human being, we have to hire. Hire for love to know the truth. First, we have to know in response to our knowledge, we'll give our life to God and we realize that children lay down our life. Usually, throws away any idea of marriage, other than marriage, 5 years, or I think I've done this for life. All these things, the knowledge that we have of God is love. So, thing we can do is sleep from another, right? Like someone, a child. In our relationship with society, right, in the broader sense of the country, there's this long-standing old covenant, I like that. Old covenant. And for the outcome of the Adam, with Abraham. We read in the book of Genesis, Abraham made covenant with other kings. So what is this notion of God? It was these covenant making ceremonies. There was a meal. The first thing they had to do, they had to want to get together and make an agreement. You and I are in a science. All NATO, right? We're all going to help each other. But it was stronger than that. Like, we're at war. I'm like, world is this covenant was together. And oath. And the oath was, I will be sick. Never enter the covenant. So I agree. Make this covenant. No matter what happens, I've got to fulfill my oath. Both agree with this. So they do. They brought a sacrificial animal and for the other. And in the presence of each other, they slit the throat of the animal. God. Because they said, I not fulfill the oath I'm making today, but God, you have the right to slit my throat and spill my blood. Read. Talk about a blood covenant. They were. Did not enter into these lightly. Reneged. Knew. Knew. Their best. And what'd they do? Deal together. Covenant deal. Because a deal brings together. Right? Bring your family together. He was always bringing. God knew what he was doing when he made this. We love eating. We have to like eating with other people. We like having nice conversations. So that's what this covenant is. If you're in dark enough, claim for God. This concept, old covenant, God made Abraham. Let's go to the mosaic. Sure. A lot more. God made a covenant, brought them out of slavery, miracle that truly was all powerful, led them through the Red Sea, which Paul says was a sacrifice. Sinai, Moses, hierarchical. God, There's three paragraphs, the people know what a blood covenant, how God was making, where they had so that God would want you. So he Moses. Moses slaughtered the righteous of blood. Then what did he do? Gathered the leaders and elders. You know how the priest goes during the season? Everybody with holy water. Moses was doing that with blood. Blood all over the people, so that people knew that it's a two-tone word that you're making with God. That people do deserve death. And people said, "We agree with everything that God said." Later, they were not last very long. We all do. So time goes on, millennia, and there are people of Israel and Judah. I not pretend my covenant. So, study away. Deserve death. But so his very nature is all loving. But, God. Oh, that was real and spiritual, going deeper, segment, history. And now, God says, you deserve to die. I'm going to come down to one of you, and you're going to kill me. I'm going to be the cause and effect for raising the dead. When you kill me, I promise you, I will die. But when we realize that the truth is not from the truth, people realize only for the tree we freely gave of himself, freely created through his own power the universe. He freely created us in his image and likeness. He tried to still be knowledge, learn, God. Or creation of absolute, which we treat the life of the temple of man, but they all are like one, not a waiting for us to act, waiting for us to watch the eyes, covenant, still alive. Blood that pulled out the Moses out of the Close it. writing, these people on scripture are like, Moses had no idea when he wrote that. All he knew was God told them. When we read it, I mean, it's just words of David and Paul. When we put it in the light of Christ, our faith is like, scripture is considered to our mind is blown away because the only conclusion we can have is nobody could have ever thought of it. A human mind could have never thought of it. There's no way. Like, if you were to invent a religion, we'd never come up with it. We can't conceive of making something. Nothing unless God said. That's a pretty weird thing. Oh, God is all mercy. So everything is going to be in that fire. Humility. What I've described as a shepherd, as a shepherd, as a heart. Definition. I was one part of it. Everything that God has revealed and the church actually covered it and explained down through the ages, that is the faith. That's the whole purpose of RCIA. That is the whole purpose to show revelation. All the creation is perfect. Everything that we're going to love, really know it, and pray on it. Our Lord. That's the faith. All of creation, life, and earth is loving gift. Then we say, what is our response with? I want incredible, mind-blowing love of God, inconceivable, and blew everybody away. That's the actual title. I think we all proclaiming this very, very clearly. God Himself. I am. I am. Well, who said I am in the Old Covenant? No way. When He comes down to earth, I am. What further means that witness being a man claim it to God? I mean, this is so clear. The clearest thing in Scripture, the most mind blowing, because if you and I were to look at it, I know. I said, just like a man sees. Nobody, like, some the Pharisees aren't believing. Some Moses didn't say clearly, I will become a man at one day, and if I wasn't a prophet, clearly like that. But God is full. That's why we can never think to be a know-it-all. Know-it-all. So, our response, what we call. That's why Jesus said, Jesus had a little faith. It's the grace that we have in the sacrament, after the state, ordination, spiritually committed, really responsible. Joining all the summary is, God's power and love is a mystery. A mystery does not mean you're not what we do. Mystery means there are solid truths here. They're so mind-blowing. The more I think about them, the more I'm blown away. The more, like, obvious. This is the greatest possible. Mystery means relevant. Like, you know how you say prayers? Maybe they can fall. Part of it. That's why it's so mind blowing that, like, when we get to heaven, we won't be able to consider ourselves as a We won't be able to, we can't consider on earth, like, everything God has in store for us. Like, I cannot hear, not hear. Whoops. All of our knowledge. Let's learn it. Sometimes pain or suffering hurts. Sometimes the only good that comes from it. And even if we cause pain, it causes suffering. It was bad. It was horrible. You know that's true, that it was true. God can still be a There's a lot of different reasons why God has allowed this. I may not see the answer. That's why all these problems, why I life. Why did dad or brother die young? You may not know this side of it. When we're confronted with suffering, what is it? Always. Suffering makes sense only. God exists. God exists. Personal and loving. Yeah. Personal and loving. Only is belief and rational. There is nothing greater that can be seen than a personal, all-loving, all-powerful God. Even as bring with you. The lady that says, and 2 weeks from now, we're going to have here, I have a capital. Over. Or. Only your created us. So out. One of them was, it's all powerful, all life. And the right, last. Right. Elijah.